فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، we are in the seerah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. We spoke about رضاع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the breastfeeding and the nursing of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Today إن شاء الله تعالى we're going to be speaking about استرضاعه في بني سعد, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was nursed in the people of بني سعد, the tribe and the people who breastfed the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم were the tribe بنو سعد. عبد المطلب, he tried to look for, this is after the Prophet's father died and the Prophet's father passed away. We all know that عبد المطلب, the Prophet's grandfather, took over the Prophet's affairs. And عبد المطلب, the grandfather, he looked for المراضع على عادة العرب, على عادة أهل مكة. The norms of the people of Mecca was they would look for somebody who would breastfeed, who would nurse the child. This was the Arabs' norms, especially أهل مكة. They were known to do that. The child is born, they would look for a person who would breastfeed, and this woman who would breastfeed the child would be from Ahlul Badiyah, from the people of the outskirts and Bedouins. And the reason why they would look for a nursing woman is as Imam al-Suhayli rahimahullah mentions. And Imam al-Suhayli, he mentions in his kitab Ar-Rawd al-Unuf, he mentions reasons why they would look for a nursing woman who would breastfeed the child. The first one is why they would look for a woman who would breastfeed the child, and she would be from what? Min al badiya. She will not be from the city. She will not be from the town. She will be from the outskirts. Why? What was the wisdom behind it? The first reason is liyansha al-tiflu fil al-arabi, that the child, he grows up with the Bedouins. فَيَكُونَ أَفْصَحَ لِسَانِهِ, and so his tongue becomes fluent in the language. The language gets tainted in the cities and the towns. It gets tainted. The Bedouins, on the other hand, are people who are أهل فصاحة, eloquent people. And so when they speak and when they discuss, their language is pure and it is untampered with. It's not tampered with. So they send the child over to the Bedouin to breastfeed. Are we all together, brothers and sisters? That's the hikmah, the first wisdom. وَلِذَلِكَ when you look at Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, the reason why he learned and he mentions why he became eloquent in the Arabic language is because he left the city. And that's what you would find in many cultures. Today, if you want to learn the Somali language, you go back to the livestock and you stay with these people. The language will be pure, it will be untampered. Are you with me? I'm guessing the same if you'd want to learn Urdu. صح? You would go to the Ahlul Badiyah, who again, their language is pure and it's untampered with. The second reason is لِيَكُونَ أَجْلَدَ لِجِسْمِهِ وَأَجْدَرَ أَلَّا يُفَارِقَ الْهَيْئَةَ الْمَعَدِيَّةِ كَمَا قَالَ عُمَرُ بْنُ الْخَطَّابِ. The child, he becomes ajlada. What does ajlada mean? It means al-quwwa. The child becomes strong. When a child grows up in the Bedouin lifestyle, he's not soft. You look at the kids that are born in cities and towns, you touch them, they start crying straight away. Soft. The kids that are born in the Bedouin lifestyle, they know what pain is. Strong. They have high level of what? Endurance. ولذلك عمر بن الخطاب used to say اخشوا شنو واخشوا شبو وخلولقوا وتمعد وتمعدوا أما وتمعددوا كأنكم معد وإياكم والتنعم. He used to say اخشوشنوا واخشوشبوا. What he means by that is be a person who's khashinan, like a wood in his religion, in his clothing, and also in his eating, and in all of his affairs. Be tough, strong. وَخْلَوْلِقُوا وَتَبَعْدَدُوا. And be like a person شَبَّ وَغَلُوْ, who is tough, strong, well-grounded individual. كَأَنَّكُمْ مَعَدٍ, like you are مَعَدٍ. مَعَدٍ is a people of the Arabs. They were known for أَهْلُ غِلَظ. They were a tough type of people. Be like that, he said. وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَتَنَعُمْ. Stay away from this chicken and chip lifestyle. تَنَعُمْ. Fish and chips. This rooster peri peri. Abbas. Leave that stuff. Live a life that doesn't involve تَنَعُمْ. That's the lifestyle of the Bedouin. You know what they would do? They would make the child go to sleep and he's hungry. And they will go to sleep. They're tough people like that. They are tough people like that. Because they have nothing to give the child. He doesn't have nothing to eat. The child learns hunger. He learns a full stomach. He learns that if he falls, he has to get up. Keep it moving. No one's going to pick you up or hug you or run to you. Especially if this woman is not your mom and she's breastfeeding you. She's getting paid to breastfeed you. She doesn't have that for you. And they like that. Also, the other benefit is أن يكون, the third benefit of why the child will be sent to the Bedouin is أن يكون أنجب للولد وأصفى للذهن. This is most pure for the mind of the child. The child, the food that he eats from that lifestyle and the kind of way he lives, his mind is not tainted, he's not programmed. He freely thinks. He's around nature. And also in terms of birth, the child, he lives a healthy lifestyle. Health-wise, this is better for him. He's eating fresh food, not things that were refrigerated for months. He eats fresh food, food that are not pasted, or a chicken and chips that if you smack a person with, he'll die. Become plastic. So this is why they would make their children go to the Bedouin lifestyle. Now inshallah ta'ala, we're going to speak about how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went into the hands of Bani Sa'd. Sa'd ibn Bakr, this qabila, how they took him. The story is as follows. The nursing women, they came to Mecca. أقبلت المراضع من البادية. The women, they came from the Badia, and they came into the city of Mecca. يلتمسنا, they were looking for تربية أولاد الأشراف. They were looking for nurturing and to raise and upbring the children of who? The Ashraf, the chiefs and the heads. Every woman was coming with the intention, with the mindset of what? That she's going to take a child by the Ashraf Ahli Mecca, the heads of the people of Mecca. And the reason why they would do this is because if she took Ashraf Ahli Mecca, if she took the chief leader of Mecca or somebody who's of a high caliber, he's got a high position, if she takes his child, most likely the money that she's going to get is going to be good. She's going to be well looked after financially. And this is what every woman is looking for. So all the women came. فَاسْتَرْضَعَ عَبْدُ الْمُطَّلِبِ حَفِيدِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ امْرَأَةً مِنْ قَبِيلَةِ سَعْدِ بْنِ بَكْرٍ. عبد المطلب, what he did was, he brought the Prophet to this place where these women come. So he brought Nabiullah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he looked in these women for somebody who can give, or somebody who would take the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and would choose him as the child in which they would breastfeed. Halima binti Abi Dhu'ayb bin al-Sa'diyya. Her name is Halima binti Abi Dhu'ayb bin al-Sa'diyya min Mudar. She's from the people of Mudar. Her and her husband Al-Harith ibn Abd al-Uzza, both of them. And her husband Al-Harith ibn Abd al-Uzza, his kunya was Abi Kabsha. And they were both from the same tribe. Halima bint Abi Dhu'ay bin al-Sa'diyah and Al-Harith ibn Abd al-Uzza, the husband of Halima al-Sa'diyah, they were both what? They were both from the same tribe. Let us listen to Halima bint Abi Dhu'ay bin al-Sa'diyah tell us the story of what took place. She's going to tell us with. She said, this is her story now. She said, خرجت من بلدها. She mentions that she left her city. مع زوجها, with her husband. Her and her husband, they left their balad, their city. وابن لها, and they had a baby they had. صغير ترضعه. She had a little child which she breastfed. And of course she would have to have a little child to breastfeed in order to be able to breastfeed, right? So she had a child which she breastfed. في نسوة من بني سعد بن بكر. And so she went with, and she came out with a group of women who were from the same tribe that she was from. Sa'd ibn Bakr. Her child was with her, and she came out with these women. تَلْتَمِسُ الرُّضَعَاءِ بِمَكَّةِ. She was looking, just like all the other women were, she was looking for a child to breastfeed from the children of Mecca. And she said, وَذَلِكَ فِي سَنَةِ الشَّهْبَاءِ. And that year was a year of الشهباء. سنة الشهباء means أيدات قحط. It was a year of drought. There was no rain. There was no crops. None of that was there. لم تبقي لنا شيئا. Nothing remained for us. We had nothing left. Everything was gone. Again, the year is a year which is قحط. We have no crops. And لم تبقي لنا شيئا. Nothing remains for us. No food, no nothing. قالت, she said, فخرجت على أتان لي قمراء. She said, I came out على أتان. I came out with a donkey, a female donkey. That was specifically ours. That's what she took as a riding beast. لي قمراء. But she said, this donkey was شديد البياض. Its whiteness was excessive. It was excessively white. معنا شارف. We also had a ناقة مسنة. We had a camel that aged. والله ما تبض بقطرة. This camel, the she camel never had one drop that came out of it. It could not produce no milk. والله ما تبض بقطرة. وَمَا نَنَامُ لَيْلَنَا. And at night we would not go to sleep. أَجْمَعَ. The whole night we won't be able to sleep. مِنْ صَبِيِّنَ الَّذِي مَعَنَا. Because of our son that is with us. We can't sleep. Why? مِنْ بُكَائِهِ مِنَ الْجُوعِ. He would cry because of the excessive hunger that our son would endure. So all night we won't be able to sleep. The she camel that we have doesn't produce no milk. The donkey that we have is white. And we have our son with us who cries all night. We can't sleep. وَمَا فِي ثَدَيَّ. And my breast has nothing. مَا يُغْنِيهِ. That which suffices it. So I can't give my son a breast milk. My breast doesn't produce anything. وَمَا شَارِفِنَا مَا يُغَذِيهِ. And the she camel that I have doesn't have any milk that I'm able to give to my son. وَلَكِنَّا كُنَّا نَرْجُ الْغَيْثَ. But the only thing that was making us go on was we were hoping rain might come down. والفرج, and Allah might give us an opening. فخرجت على أتاني تلك فلقد أدمت الركبة حتى شق ذلك عليهم ضعفا وعجفا. She said, I came out with my donkey that I had. When I came, the hardship and the weakness and the pain that we endured was excessive. The donkey was slow. The word عجفا means huzal. The donkey is weak. It can't walk properly. So everybody's passing us. Everybody, we have to say to them, please wait for us. Can't wait. Don't go too fast from us. And we keep becoming, we're dragging the whole group of women who are with us. حتى قدمنا مكة. Until we finally made it to Mecca. نلتمس الرضعاء. So we started to look at the children we're going to breastfeed. فَمَا مِنَّا إِمْرَأَةٌ There is not a woman from amongst us. إِلَّا وَقَدْ عُرِضَ عَلَيْهَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ The Prophet was brought to them. Every single woman, the Prophet was brought to her. And فَتَأْبَاهُ She would refuse him. She said, no, I don't want this kid. Why? إِذَا قِيلَ لَهَا أَنَّهُ يَتِيمٌ They were told that this child is an orphan. His father died. So each woman, whenever she's told the Prophet ﷺ, and they ask about his history, who is he, what is he like, and they tell him, and they are informed that the Prophet is an orphan, every woman would say, no, I don't want to breastfeed. And I told you why they would do that. Why would they do that? Because they thought an orphan doesn't have no money. There's nothing worldly gain that's going to come from it. And this teaches us a lesson, which is, sometimes something might look some way to you. And you might not think to yourself that it might happen in this way. But we'll see the story of Halimata bint Abi Du'ayban and how everything changed for her and how things became. She said every woman would reject it. وَذَلِكَ أَنَّا إِنَّمَا كُنَّا نَرْجُ الْمَعْرُوفَ مِنْ أَبِي الصَّبِي The reason is because we were hoping that if a child we took, the father we would get good from him. He would take care of us financially. فَكُنَّا نَقُولُ We would say, يَتِيم وَمَا عَسَىٰ أَن تَصْنَعْ أُمُّهُ وَجَدُّ We would all say, what could his mother and his granddad do for this boy? Like, we weren't hoping anything from the Prophet. فَكُنَّا نَكْرَهُ لِذَلِكَ So we disliked to take him. فَمَا بَقِيَتْ امْرَأَةٌ قَدِمَتْ مَعِي إِلَّا أَخَذَتْ رَضِيعًا غَيْرِي Every woman ended up taking a child with them. They turned down the Prophet, they all took a child. She said, except me. I was the only person who had no one to take. فَلَمَّا أَجْمَعْنَا انْطِلَاقًا When we all came together to leave and go back, قُلْتُ لِصَاحِبِي I said to my friends, I'm my husband, وَاللَّهِ by Allah, إِنِّي لَأَكْرَهُ أَنْ أَرْجِعَ مِنْ بَيْنِ صَوَاحِبِي I dislike to go back with my friends, وَلَمْ أَخُذْ رَضِيعًا And I haven't taken a child to breastfeed. وَاللَّهِ لَأَذْهَبَنَّ إِلَى ذَلِكَ الْيَتِيمِ I'm going to go back to that orphan child. فَلَآخُذَنَّهُ And I'm going to take him with me. قَالَ Then her husband said to her, لَا عَلَيْكَ أَن تَفْعَلِي عَسَى اللَّهُ أَن يَجْعَلَ لَنَا فِيهِ بَرَكَةً He said, no, take him. Like, there's nothing on you to do so. There's no problem if you do that. There may be possible that Allah may place barakah in this child for us. She said, فَذَهَبْتُ I went back to Abdul Muttalib. إليه فأخذته I took the Prophet from her. I took the Prophet from him. وما حملني على أخذه إلا أني لم أجد غيره. And حليمه بنت أبي ذؤيب she said the only reason why I took him is I had no one else to take. She said فلما أخذته when I took him رجعت به إلى رحلي I took him back to my رحل my riding beast and my camel and my belongings. I brought him to there. In other words, she wants to leave now. فَلَمَّا وَضَعْتُ فِي حِجْرِي I placed him in my thighs. Because now she has to breastfeed the child. She said, I placed the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام on my thighs, على حجري. أَقْبَلَ عَلَيْهِ ثَدَيَّ The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he came towards ثَدْيَايَ towards my breasts. بِمَا شَاءَ مِنْ لَبَنِ He went towards my breast. And she said, he started to suck alayhi salatu wasalam milk out of it. فَشَرِبَ He drank. حَتَّى رَوِيَ Until it quenched his thirst alayhi salatu wasalam. وَشَرِبَ مَعَهُ And then after he finished what he wanted and he went to sleep alayhi salatu wasalam due to the fact that the milk filled him up. She said, I put him down. I took his brother, meaning her other son. And I lifted him and I put him on my thighs. حتى روية until he became full. ثم نام and they both slept. وما كنا ننام معه قبل ذلك. And this, he's never ever slept before my own son. My son had never slept before because of the fact that he ate. It filled him up. وقام زوجي إلى شاريفنا تلك. And she said, my husband, he stood up to the she camel. فإذا هي حافل. When my husband stood up and he went to the she camel, the breasts of the she camel were full. They were full. Hafil means a kathirul laban. The milk in their breasts were bursting, the breasts were bursting due to the milk that were in it. فَحَلَبَ مِنْهَا وَشَرِبْ. He squeezed the milk out of it and he drank it. وَشَرِبْتُ مَعَهُ. And I drank with him. حَتَّى انْتَهَيْنَا رِيًّا وَشِبَعًا. Until it quenched our thirst and our hunger. The she camel that could not produce a drop, me, I got full from it. And my husband, he drank and he became full from it. حَتَّى انْتَهَيْنَا رِيًّا وَشِبَعًا. فبتنا بخير ليلة. We slept that night, the best night of our life. قالت, she said, يقول صاحبي حين أصبحنا, when the morning, the dawn broke, my friends from سعد بن بكر in the tribe, they said to me, تعلمي والله يا حليمة لقد أخذت نسمة مباركة. They said to her, حليمة, you know that you've taken a blessed child with you. The child that you have with you is a blessed child. قالت, she said, فقلت والله إني لأرجو ذلك. She said, by Allah, I hope that that is the case. And that is the reality. قالت, she said, ثم خرجنا. Then we embarked on our journey. وركبت أتاني. And then I went on my donkey. The weak, ضعيف donkey. She said, I went on it. وحملت عليه عليها معي. And I took the Prophet with me on the camel, donkey. فوالله, by Allah. لقطعت بالركب ما يقدر عليه شيء من حمرهم حتى إن صواحب لا يقولن لي. My donkey cut distance. The speed that my donkey was going on, it cut so much distance and so fast that my friends were saying to me, يا ابنة ابن أبي ذؤيب, the daughter of Abi Dhuayb, ويحك أربعي, destruction be to you. But that's not a curse that they say. They said, أربعي, be calm and collective and easy. علينا, on us. أليست هذه أتانك, was this not your previous donkey that you had before? التي كنت خرجت عليها, the donkey that you came out with, is this not the one? فأقول لهن, I will respond by saying, بلى, والله, it's the same one. Of course, it's the same donkey that I had before. فيقولن, and then they would say to me, والله إن لها شأنا. Wallahi, this donkey has affairs. And in your matters, there are affairs. Something is in your matter today. Something is in this issue of yours. Ya Halima bint Abi Dhuayb. قالت, she said, ثم قدمنا منازلنا. Then we came to our houses. من بلاد بني سعد. The people of بني سعد. وما أعلم أرضعا من أرض الله أجدب منها. She said, when we came to our houses, I do not know. I have no knowledge of a land from the lands of Allah. Ajdaba. Ma ma'ana ajdaba? Meaning that has more greenery, more grass, more crops, more vegetation, more grains than this, the land that we are at. So green. فَكَانَتْ غَنَمِي تَرُوحُ عَلَيَّ حِينَ قَدِمْنَا بِهِ. She said, my goats would go out عَلَيَّ حِينَ قَدِمْنَا بِهِ مَعَنَا شِبَعًا لُبَّنًا. They would go, my camels, sorry, my sheep and my goats would go, and they would eat from the grass and the greenery, and they would get filled, the milk would fill them up. And then we would take the milk from the goats and the sheep, and we will drink it. وَمَا يَحْلَبُ إِنسَانٌ قَطْرَةَ لَبَنٍ. No one else would be able to get one drop of milk from their goats and camels, sheep. وَلَا يَجِدُهَا فِي ضَرْعٍ حَتَّى. They wouldn't even find that in the milks of their goats. حَتَّى كَانَ الْحَاضِرُونَ مِنْ قَوْمِنَا يَقُولُونَ لِرُعْيَانِهِمْ وَيْلَكُمْ إِسْرَحُوا حَيْثُ يَسْرَحُ رَاعِي بِنْتِ أَبِي دُعَيْبٍ. They said, the people who owned sheep, they would say to their shepherds, shepherd, go. Go to where Bint Abi Dhuayb is going. Where is she going? Where is her sheep getting the greenery from? Go. So when the sheep drink and they eat from the greenery that we can get, the milk of our sheep can be a lot. Go to those places that she's going with her sheep, and she's going there with her goats. Go there. فَتَرُوحُ أَغْنَامُهُمْ جِيَاعًا. And so what happens is that the goats would do that hungry, and they would come back filled with milk. فَهَذِهِ. This all, it shows barakatu Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the barakah in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala Halimah al-Sa'diyah, in Halimah al-Sa'diyah and her husband al-Harith, the blessing that the Prophet brought for them. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stayed with Halimah al-Sa'diyah. He remained with them until 2 years went by. She breastfed him, she took care of him. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he reached 2 years of age. How old was he when he came to her in the first place? Does anyone know how old she was? How old the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was when Halimah al-Sa'diyah took over? How long did Halimah al-Sa'diyah keep the Prophet for in total? Yeah? So she took, after 2 years, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she kept him for 2 years, she took him to his mother. And when she took him to his mother, she asked the Prophet's mother if she could keep him longer. She begged the Prophet's mother, can I keep him longer? Don't leave this kid with me. And she told the Prophet's mother about the blessing that he's brought her. She said to him, لو تركت بني عندي, if you leave your son نبي الله محمد with me, حتى يغلظ, until he becomes much stronger and tougher, فإني أخشى عليه وباء مكة, I fear for him the illnesses of Mecca that it might befall him. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, after 2 years again, he was taken back to إلى بادية بني سعد. When بادية بني سعد, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken there, an event took place. Something that shook Halima bint Abi Dhu'aybin. It shook her and it moved her. This is the hadithatu shaq sadr al-sharifi alayhi salatu wa sallam. It is the splitting of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's chest. The Prophet's chest got opened. And this was when he was in fi badiyati bani Sa'd. He was in the badiyah of the people of Bani Sa'd, alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is narrated authentically in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad rahimahullah. Al-Hakim narrated in his Mustadrak min hadith Utbah ibn Abdi al-Aslami, that a man asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said to the Prophet, كيف كان أول شأنك يا رسول الله. He said, O Messenger of Allah, how was your affairs, your first early affairs? Referring to, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sometimes they used to see the sign, as Anas ibn Malik said, there was a little sign, a little stitches that were on the Prophet's chest, alayhi salatu wasalam. So the Prophet is going to tell us the story of what happened. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, كانت, it was حاضنتي من بني سعد بن بكر. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as nursing woman, and those who the person who took care of him was the people of Sa'd ibn Bakr. We mentioned Halima bint Abi Dhu'ay bin Sa'diyah was the woman who took care of the Prophet. He said, فانطلقت, I went out, أنا وابن لها, me and her son. And remember we mentioned before, Halima bint Abi Dhu'ayb, when she came to Mecca and she wanted to take the Prophet, who did she have with her? She had her son. So she brought, so the Prophet said, I and the son of Halima bint Abi Dhu'ayb went out together. And we went out fi bahmin. And the word bahmin is jam'u bahama. So she said. So he said, "Walam na'khud ma'ana zadan." We went out to the outskirts. and we never took with us any provision. I said to him, Ya Akhi, my brother, idhab fa'tini bizadin min indi ummina. We went out, me and him, and so I said to him, the Prophet saying, I said to him, to my brother, go and get us from our mother. Who is he referring to the Prophet as his mother here? He's referring to Halima bint Abi Du'ayb al-Sa'diyah radiallahu ta'ala anha. Halima bint Abi Du'ayb, did she take Islam? She took Islam. Her and her husband, Al-Harith ibn Abdul Uzza, they both came and took Islam from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, فَأَتَيْنَا بِزَادٍ مِنْ عِنْدُ أُمِّنَا فَانْطَلَقَ أَخِي, my brother went, meaning the son of Halima bint Abi Du'ayb. وَمَكَنْثُ عِنْدَ الْبَهَمِ فَأَقْبَلَ طَيْرَانٌ أَبْيَضَانِ كَأَنَّهُمَا نَسْرَانِ. So the Prophet ﷺ, he said, I stayed with the Bahama. And the Bahama is the walad al-da'an. Mutton. Does anyone know what that means? Yeah? Is that a lamb? Huh? A sheep. Yeah? It's a sheep. How do you guys distinguish between a sheep and a lamb? Just a wool. So you're saying in hot countries there's no sheep? Yeah? Hey, Akhi.
Mutton are the babies of the sheep.
They're the babies of the sheep. Yes. Sahih, that's.
Okay, the mutton is the big lamb, the lady lamb, and the lamb itself is a baby lamb.
Say that one more time, slowly. A mutton is what?
The adult version, and lamb is the baby one.
The lamb is the baby one.
Yeah, lamb is the baby, and mutton is the adult.
So the lamb. The baby of the lamb is called mutton.
No, the lamb is the baby.
The lamb is the baby of a?
The adult.
When it's called a lamb, it's a baby. When it's called a mutton, it's actually when it's an adult. Yeah?
You may have beef is the meat of the cow.
Yeah? It's the other way around.
I'll explain it to you. I'll explain it to
you. Yeah? You're the butcher. Yeah, ikhwah, he's the butcher. Yeah? Your dad's a butcher. No, he's a butcher. Now for Somalis, they say, my dad has a camel. What's better is to say, I have a donkey. Sah? He's a butcher. Your dad, that's far. That's a senate. That's a chain. Ya Abbas. His father. So one more time, repeat it. So I learned the word. A lamb is when it's a baby, and the mutton is when it's a adult. And what's a sheep?
Sheep is a female version. It's actually the same as mutton, but it's a female version.
It's a baby version?
No, it's the adult.
Oh, the mutton's the adult, sir.
Mutton or
sheep. So, in Arabic, it's called al-da'an. Like, in the difference between al-da'an is that, is the mutton a female or a male? It can be any, right?
Goat is usually refers to the male one, the one with the.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So the mutton is a male?
No, mutton and sheep refer to female.
They refer to shima. Then the word al-ba'an in the Arabic language is al-dhakar wal-untha. It's the male and the female. So we don't have a precise definition yet. The word ba'an, but you have an idea, right? What's happening here? So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, I stayed with the ba'd. And فَأَقْبَلَ الطَّيْرَانِ أَبْيَضَانِ, two birds, white birds, they came down. كَأَنَّهُمَا, and they were as though, we'll stop there inshallah ta'ala. The salah is close. Anything which I have said that was wrong, فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولِ بَرِيئَانِ مِنُهُ. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.